Để mở đầu cho chương trình của ngày hôm nay, kênh xin kính chúc tất cả quý cô chú và anh chị em cùng gia quyến một năm mới thật nhiều sức khỏe, hạnh phúc, an khang. Và tiếp theo sau đây là tường thuật trực tiếp bài phát biểu của cựu Tổng thống Donald Trump đã phát biểu sau khi ông giành được chiến thắng tại tiểu bang Nevada, Las Vegas vào tối hôm qua.
I just want to say that this has been an incredible period of time. I think for our country, for the world has not been like this for many, many years. When you look at the attack on Israel or the attack on Ukraine with Russia, this would have never happened. The Israeli attack would have never happened. Inflation would have never happened. The world would be a much different place right now. And we're going to make sure. And we're going to bring it back fast, and we're going to bring it back very, very strong, very, very strong. But, and it's so sad to see, it's all of the death that you've witnessed with Ukraine and Russia fighting, and again what happened in Israel, all of the death and all of the destruction of cities and places that are ancient places in a sense. Ancient buildings being knocked down, you can never replace it. But all those people that died, most importantly, would have never happened. And we're going to change it. We're going to change it around. We're going to get it back to normalcy. It can't continue like this. The world is exploding. Our country is doing horribly. We're a laughing stock all over the world. We were respected. We were respected like never before. Just 3 years ago, We are now a laughing stock all over the world. We're not respected even a little bit. And you understand why. You understand why. You need leadership. And this country does not have leadership. It has no idea what's happening. It's lost its way. It's a failing nation. And we're not going to have a failing nation much longer. I just want to really thank the great people of Nevada. Because this was a turnout. I don't know if you know, you broke the all-time record. The all-time caucus record was broken. And we kept waiting and waiting because they're all flowing in from all parts of your state. They all want to be. I said, well, wait. But I said, they're going to be very upset when they come here. And everyone's gone. But I said, we have to start. But this has been a tremendous state. And, you know, if we win this state, we easily win the election in November. We have to win the election. And you know, great countries. Thank you. But great countries are all about a lot of things, but two things in particular. You have to have strong borders, and you have to have free, fair, and honest elections. And we don't have either. And we're going to have them back. We had 3 years ago, we had the strongest border in the history of our country, and we were doing great. And our economy was the best, and we rebuilt our military, so many things. And then you had the tragedy of the Afghanistan surrender. That was nothing less than a surrender. And President Putin watched that, and he saw that, and he said, wow, this could be my chance to go and do what I wanted to do. They never would have happened. It would have never happened. But he went in and he did what he wanted to do. But we're going to bring the world back. We're going to bring the world back to normalcy. And this country is going to be the leader. And we're going to be also, at the same time, focused on a thing called America First. Right? Peace through strength. You know, a few terms that are very descriptive, but peace through strength. There's no reason for this. I left and I see that all over the Middle East, they're bombing again. I said, I remember that before I came, everyone was bombing. You don't have to bomb. We defeated ISIS, radically defeated ISIS. And then we had no wars. You know, they say, first in 72 years, first president. I remember on the debate stage with Hillary Clinton. I don't use the word crooked anymore. I use that word for somebody else. I retired it. That was a good night for Hillary. She was very happy that night. That was one of the best nights. I retired the name from Hillary and put it on to Joe, Crooked Joe. But we have a country that has tremendous potential, but
If anything bad happens in this next election, if this election isn't won by us, we're not going to have a country anymore. We're not going to have a country. So I appreciate the tremendous record that you set tonight. You set an all-time record. And really it was a tremendous turnout. And they had lines going back. And they sort of knew who was going to win. You get 98%.
We wanted to get over 80, and we got 98. And also, if you remember, and last night, you know what happened last night, right? None of the above. So I'd like to congratulate none of the above. I was one of those none of ever aboves. I was one of them. No, I watched that last night, and they won by 44 points, none of the above. So I want to congratulate. But seriously, we have to get back. This was a great day. This was a great night. Our Supreme Court hopefully will be doing something in terms of helping our country and preserving democracy. We have to preserve our democracy. And I think they had a very, very interesting day and a very beautiful day, perhaps. I think it was really a very beautiful sight to watch. And it's the way it's supposed to be. And hopefully the decision will be a very important decision. But there's never been anything like it in the polls. We're leading everybody. We are right now. Is there any way we can call the election for next Tuesday? That's all I want. I want to call the election for next Tuesday, but we're going to make our country great again. We're going to make it great. We're going to make it greater than ever before. The enthusiasm and the turnout, Doug and I were talking, I don't think you've ever seen anything like it, right? You were at various of the caucus sites, and they both came back, and they said, we've never seen anything like it. Would you like to say a few words? Please.
Thank you, President Trump. I just want to build on that. At the caucus sites that Catherine and I were at tonight, the lines were stringing around the block in those buildings, people waiting out in the cold. And I do want to say thank you to all of you and all the people in Nevada that voted tonight, because you're sending a signal to the nation. One is that this primary is over. President Trump has won. That's the signal you're sending. And the second thing that really matters is that all of you that voted tonight, that came out tonight, need to show up in November, but bring somebody with you, because Nevada is going to be a swing state and President Trump is going to win it in November.
About Woody. He's been my friend for so many years. Do you mind if I let him speak for a second? Please. Woody Johnson.
Oh, what a good day. I don't know if anybody listened to the Supreme Court arguments today, but boy, I've never seen arguments like that. Totally in favor of the president's position. Excellent. So that was good, but this is even better. Winning Nevada is propelling us. We're going to win the election. And this is good. You're going to see Donald J. Trump as another great president.
Thank you. So, God bless you all. We have to save our country. We're going to save our country. We're going to make America greater than it's ever been. We have to stop it. We have to close up our borders. We have to close them up. I believe you'll have 19 million people by the time this guy is out of office. 19 million, that's substantially bigger than New York State. And these people, many of them are coming from prisons and jails, they're coming from mental institutions, and they're terrorists. And you see what's happening. I don't know if you've been watching your news lately. I kept saying, crime is through the roof, all over our country. And I kept saying, when is it going to be that I don't see any migrant crime? Well, guess what? It's happening at levels now like nobody's ever seen. And we can't let it happen. So get ready. We're going to get out there. We're going to win. We're going to have a great election. We're going to turn our country around. You're going to be so happy. We were energy independent. Think of it. 3 years ago, we were energy independent. And now we're trying to buy from Venezuela, You're getting your. And remember this: we have more. I call it liquid gold. We have more liquid gold under our feet, Doug. You know that better than anybody. We have more liquid gold under our feet than any other nation, more than Saudi Arabia, more than Russia, more than anybody. And we're going to take advantage of it. So go back home, rest, and then come back, because we're going to turn this whole thing around. If we win the state of Nevada, it's over for them, and our country's going to be better, greater, bigger, more beautiful than ever before. Thank you very much. We appreciate it. We love you. God bless you all. God bless you. Thank you.